You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, presented by the Only One Media Group. This is the people's choice for quality interviews, celebrities, and special guests. Hosted by demetrius-reynolds. Call in to join the mix at 701-801-9813. For the complete archive of episodes, visit onlyonemediagroup.com and be sure to like us on Facebook at Vigilantes Radio. We welcome all. Enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Demetrius whodini-blak Reynolds. Enjoy the show.
Yo, 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 what is up, guys? Welcome to another incredible episode of Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio, and I am your host, Dini. We have a very special guest for you guys, and you definitely want to stick around for that. And as a matter of fact, text your buddies, family members, or even share it on social media right now and let them know that we are about to dive deep into another interview. Before I bring my guest on, I do want to say that you have to let it flow. You know, the more you give of yourself, the more fully you become yourself. Hiding everything inside and keeping it all for yourself will only imprison you. Let the value of your life flow out from you in a constant stream of serenity and joy, or sincerity, rather. The more good things you send forth, the more good and valuable things you'll experience flowing into your life. The most miserable people are those who care only about themselves, who understand only their own troubles, who see only their own perspectives. Real and lasting fulfillment comes to those who live beyond themselves. And when your goal is to accumulate more and more for yourself at the expense of everything else, you'll end up with nothing but the empty artifacts of life. But when you seek to expand your life by giving your best, you'll know the rich fulfillment that comes from truly living beyond yourself. If there's anything that's failing to flow, you know, into your life, it's because that same thing is not flowing out from your life. So give the best of yourself and you'll experience the best of what life has to offer. Take that from me, Coach Dini. That is my word, and word is bond.
Have you struggled budgeting your finances? Don't worry, you're not alone. Humbledbudget.com, that's HumbledBudget.com, is the help and resource you've been searching for. Humbledbudget.com is a personal finance and educational website with a great variety of topics when it comes to budgeting, taxes, investing, and the popular topic of FIRE, financial independence, retire early. Humbledbudget.com has a goal, and that's to help you reach your financial dreams, no matter what your goals are when it comes to finances. It doesn't matter where you start, where you come from, or where you are right now. HumbledBudget.com can help. What are you waiting for? Take that first step to the financial life you've dreamed of and go to HumbledBudget.com. That's HumbledBudget. HumbledBudget.com.
Well, again, I want to welcome you guys to the show. You're listening to VRL. That's Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. Our interviews are designed to go beyond the music, news, books, art, acting, films, technology, education, entrepreneurship, entertainment, and sometimes even past that thing that we call the ego. Our interviews are designed to go behind the scenes and into the minds of these incredible human beings. You know, the ones who are out there giving it their all for me, for you, and for the world. Well, from the heart of Los Angeles to the forefront of conscious hip-hop, Proclaim stands out as a rapper with a mission. His latest album is titled Climbing Higher. It's a testament to his journey from the streets of East L.A. to the halls of academia and the therapist's office. Proclaim's music transcends the typical rap narrative, weaving his experiences as a past gangster, a psychotherapist, and a philosopher into soul-stirring lyrics. So get ready to dive into the world of a rapper who's not just making beats, but making a difference. And with that, let's welcome him to the show. Proclaim, welcome, welcome. How's it going?
I'm doing well, thank you. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely, man. We are excited that you are here. So again, man, welcome to the show. Let's talk about your album. It's titled Climbing Higher. This marks a significant milestone in your career, so congratulations on that. Yeah, man, can you share with us what this album represents for you personally?
Yeah, no, absolutely. And yeah, once again, just thank you for having me. You know, it represents, I think, like a return. Like I thought that I was sort of done with music, and I had made two albums in my 20s, and I thought that chapter was closed. And then when I met my wife, it just came back. It just the urge to write music. I got, after my first two albums, I became really career driven. I went to graduate school. I became a therapist, and you know, launched my own private practice, and just went down that road. And so this album, you know, represents a return to music that I think sort of represents like listening to your inner voice. There was like a calling, and it was like a struggle to kind of listen to that, like this calling back. And then also, you know, in that was the struggle of like trying to take my music to the next level. Like I realized that my first two albums were just not up to par in terms of like mixing and mastering and overall sound quality. So then I had to like really dig deep and learn a lot about mixing and mastering to get it to a sound quality level that I liked and that I was at least pleased with. By no means am, you know, do I consider myself a mixing mastering engineer at all, but you know, did do some time in the trenches to learn some skills that would at least get it to the level I liked. And that was a lot of struggle, trial, error, you know, learning in YouTube University. You know, I have two master's degrees in psychology and philosophy. And, you know, with that, there's these, you know, you take these courses, you have instructors, you have classes, and you show up, you write these papers, and you get your degrees. But with this, it was just all self-taught, and there is no degree, there is no instructors, it's YouTube University. I mean, there are courses that you can take, but it was just, you know, learning one thing at a time, tedious. It was a lot harder, I would say, and it was years of writing the songs, mixing, mastering, filtering out which ones I'm going to use. And so I think that's kind of why I titled it Climbing Higher, because it was trying my best to take my music to the next level, even though I always approach everything with a beginner's mind and realize that I still have a lot to learn and a lot to grow in those realms.
Absolutely, man. So in between that period in your 20s and then coming back to music after marriage, I believe you are a different person at this point. When you decided to get back into music, did you know what type of subjects you were going to rap about?
Not particularly. It was a calling, and you know, my first two albums didn't really write too many songs about like romance or love or love interest. And so, you know, having met my wife, that sort of prompted that. Some of those topics, not a lot, but just kind of listen to what was coming out from inside and manifesting that. And I think that's sort of the, for me at least, the mysterious quality of songwriting that I don't know where it comes from or how. And I struggle with it a lot because I wish I could just do it more frequently or had more of a disciplined practice. And you know, kind of like Eminem, you know, he's just constantly writing. And for me, it's like a struggle to write. And that's kind of Leonard Cohen, who's kind of like one of the great musical writers. You know, that's kind of his progress. He just has to brute force, make himself sit there and do it. And I think that's kind of mine too. And then these things just came forward, these topics. It wasn't necessarily planned. And I kind of like that because it kind of speaks to the, like I said, the magical and mysterious quality of it. And it just came forth, and I just kind of listened to that.
Yeah, that reminds me, as you were speaking, you know, the restraint of sitting down to write a song. There's a book called The War of Art.
Oh yeah,
Yeah, yeah. Man, it was my Bible because you could listen to the audiobook in one sitting. So that used to be my Bible every morning because it was such a pain for me to be a professional. You know, it's like, it's like the toughest thing just not to tell someone off. You know, this is my business. Why can't I just do what I want? And then you have to force yourself to be the professional, to sit and do the things that are tedious. It's repetition and it's muscle memory at some point, right?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah.
For sure, for sure. All right, man. So we've been talking about movies and particular characters in movies and how sometimes our life can reflect that on screen. Is there a particular movie or character from a movie that resonates with you and you like, okay, that's me?
I like Neo from The Matrix. I know that's kind of cliche, but I like the Neo character, the sort of he's in this life and just living it out and not sure, like something's wrong with the world, but he doesn't know what it is, and then he's kind of pulled into this other life. That's kind of what the album felt like, and then he's kind of pulled down this tumultuous journey to kind of become, you know, who he is in the end, and kind of realizing that, you know, there's lots of different versions of the same story. But in the end, he kind of realizes that he's the one. I don't think I've realized that yet. I really struggle with like my identity as like a music artist and what that means. It's very ethereal and hard to nail down. For me, I would like to get to that point. I think that the album is, you know, climbing higher, trying to get there, like to that point where I can really feel it. I think there's another movie called The Last Dragon. I don't know if you've ever heard of it, but it's like a spoof, like on kung fu movies, and he's like looking for the master, and in the end he realizes that he's the master. It's very, you know, the same sort of Neo story motif is told in various movies, and I don't know, I kind of like that character.
Sure. So the making of Climbing Higher, I think it took you 5 years to fully develop this album. I like stuff like that when it takes time, you know, because to me that's 5 years of living, of life experiences that can go into an album, you know, and really mark an experience for the listener. But what were some of the challenges or even triumphs that you experienced while creating Climbing Higher?
Let's say, like, trying to decide which songs are going to go on, which ones are not. As opposed to like the previous albums that you asked me that were more kind of like directed, like, okay, my first album was in a sense like more philosophical and kind of had a lot of philosophical topics, and then the second album was like more political, and this one had like a more diverse range of songs and trying to organize them in a way that made sense. So I think that was pretty challenging. And then just getting the mixing and the mastering down in a way that I liked, that was also quite challenging. The delivery, which I still struggle with, but just trying to come down to a final work and organization of songs in an organization that I liked, and actually got a lot of input from people to help with that. So that was a major struggle, I would say.
Yeah. So we're going to play Personal Expressions, which is a remix from your first album. What would motivate you to resurface this record and put a new spin to it?
Well, I guess back to your other question, like that was kind of a something too, like in an area of growth that was. The first version of this song is kind of sad. It kind of has this old taxi cab sample to it, and I heard this beat, and it just kind of was like, oh wow, you could use, you know, you could do this song to that, and I've never done that. Like, I've never done a remix of any of my songs, so I just thought like that. Well, that's something new to try, and it just is in a different key and a different vibe, and so. Kind of brings it to life, and the story's still there, like which is kind of interesting and odd, because I remember like you saying like, well, I'm a different person now, But that story, that version of me, or that truth, that narrative is still true as well. Like, that hasn't changed. You know, like, there are some things that change and some things that don't. And so, you know, that story is still there and still true. So just wanted to tell that in a different way, that more with music, with a beat and with a vibe that kind of like represents a more contemporary sound.
Absolutely. All right, listeners, are you ready for some music? We have Personal Expressions, the remix by Proclaim, and then we'll be right back to put them in our, well, no, well, we may do that. Do you know about our hot seat?
Yeah, I read the, yes.
All right, cool. So that's right. When we come back, we'll put Proclaim in our traditional hot seat where he gets to perform for us, whether that's rapping, singing, poetry, spoken word, telling a joke, telling a story from his life, playing an instrument, or just giving some real cool advice. But for right now, here it is, Personal Expressions, the remix.
No matter what anybody tells you, words and ideas can change the world.
Yeah, what up, bro? It's just a little introduction. Thought I'd tell you a little bit about myself. Some things I've been through that brought me here today. Check it out. Former gangster, former thug, yes, I was a drug dealer. Now I rock mics, just call me the soul healer. My ex-girlfriend from back in high school. Well, two kids talking about I still get high too. Bitch tore back, couldn't believe I used to Mac. Used and lost like weed sacks, keys under doormats. I got my education and my songs, sing along. Over many years, music's always kept me strong. Self-destruction, no, thug lifestyle said no. I wanna end up dead, fucked up in jail. All her life, wasted life, many sad stories to tell. Still I got lots, like memories of cold cots. Screaming sets at my enemies, just making hearts rot. My pops was a good man, maybe I was bad seed. Planted in this earth like a stick of chronic weed. Proceed with need, analyze the past I'll put behind me. Living best ways all over nations you can find me. Stubborn as hell, still punch the wheel and hate lines. I'm sharing personal rhymes, hoping that you'll see a sign and change your life in time. Maybe I can free your mind. I found a home here, spilling words up in your ear. You can feel me through the fear, memories we hold dear. We all have a right just to kick a little verse that remembers good times. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine. Think I'll die another day, but tomorrow's eyes away. Hope to see the UK, Pink Floyd, Pompeii. Tomorrow's never promised, still an optimist I am. Used to think I was damned, I was phony Christian. Didn't have a single clue why I was put up on this earth. Struggling from birth, all the homies flamed turf. Before I joined a gang, I was just a class clown. It put me in a scene that it forced me to be down. For the homies, for the crew, for everybody that I knew. Being hard wasn't cool, everybody plays the fool. Sometimes best comedian in school, never did I fight fair. The hood molded me to America's nightmare. American me, watching too much menace to society. Remember hard tests, rolling rivals' nests, putting bullets in their chest. Some shit I couldn't do, shit I couldn't mess with. Still I got busted for some bullshit didn't do. Feeling like OJ Stoop, Tupac too. Oh yes, this shit is personal, appreciate confession. No hip-hop lesson, this is just a self-expression. I found a home here, spilling words up in your ear. You can feel me through the fear, memories we hold dear. We all have a right just to kick a little verse that remembers good times. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine. Now I'm here up in your ear, just clearing my guts out. Going down clear like beer with the suds out. We travel across lands, better break your huts out. Indigenous, organic, trying to live up off this earth. My peoples come first, like in worst comes to worst. Gotta get up out that jail, and I ended up in college. Through the whole deal, temporary alcoholic. Full-time weed head, guess I'm often brain dead. I'ma leave you tainted, somehow you'll be affected. Just listen, pay attention, only thing that I've expected. Easily granted, cause you're listening for now. I balance everything, like the concept of the Tao. I'm buying out the Dow, while the Jones gets boned. I'm back to being a clown, and I finally found a home. Yes, I finally found a home. I'm back to being a clown and I finally found a home. I
I found a home here, spilling words up in your ear. You can feel me through the fear, memories we hold dear. We all have a right just to kick a little verse that remembers good times. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine. For the personal rhymes, thank you for listening to mine.
All right, dope track. Welcome back, guys. That was Proclaim, Personal Expressions remix from the album Climbing Higher. Let's go ahead and bring Proclaim back. Yo, welcome back. You're back live with us and in our hot seat. What are you going to perform for us?
All right, thank you, man. I appreciate that. I'm going to do the second verse from my song called Timing on the album Climbing Higher. This is kind of like one of the first things I wrote to, like, coming back to music, which is ironic because I remember you asked me about that, and this just kind of came in that process of coming back. So that's what it's called. So this is the second verse from Timing on Climbing Higher. Goes something like this. I took a break from music. I had so many things to do, but now it's like a weapon that I used to blast you, and I'm staying thankful. Everything has come together. I traveled underground to come back as something better. Like Malcolm in prison, Mandela in prison. Like Pac when he came out and tried to change the system. I know my history, trying to solve the mystery. So in life I victory, I keep growing like a seed or a tree or a child. I want to run wild, I want to be free, and I want to have style. So far I got both, I got love and it shows. From my head to my toes, to the words that I chose. I'm trying everything. I'm like Jimmy Iovine and Suge Knight all in one. Half hood, half brain, half moon, half sun. Jumping at the right time like a sprinter to the gun. Focus at the right moment, trying to get the job done. I'm Pac, I'm Pun, I'm Biggie all in one. I'm a star, I'm a sun. Universe is the one. I came from elements of the Big Bang. All came together just to do the damn thing. At the perfect time, like a soldier on the line, jumping right on a grenade just to try to save a life, trying to do the right thing. Be patient, be humble, for the perfect timing. Thank you.
Yo, dope, man. Where can our listeners connect with you online?
You can find me on Instagram at Proclaim Music or Proclaim_music, and also on my website is www.proclaimcreations.com. I think those are the two best places to find me.
All right, before we let you go, man, what advice would you give to young artists who are trying to find their unique voice in this music industry?
I would say to find your unique voice, listen inside and pay attention to when something feels like it's not you. Like in The Republic, in Plato's Republic, he spends a good chunk of the book. The question, The Republic is about what is justice, and he spends a good chunk of the book talking about what justice is not. And Socrates does this a lot too. He'll ask somebody a question, and then there's a process of deduction, the process of eliminating like what you are not. And so to find what you are, sometimes the best way to do that is to really pay attention to what you are not. And you try something and it doesn't, you listen to your body, and when it doesn't feel right, it doesn't feel natural, then you know that's not you. You know that's not meant for you, that's not your style, that's not your voice. And then when you feel something that kind of clicks and is like, okay, that feels more like me, you roll with that and you grow with that and you flow with that. So that would be probably the best advice I could give to a young artist.
All right. Good stuff. Well, Proclaim, man, your journey from the streets of East LA to become a conscious rapper, psychotherapist, and educator is nothing short of inspiring. Climbing Higher is not just an album. Listeners, it's a narrative of transformation, struggle, and hope. Your ability to intertwine your life experiences with your music is a true art form. And thank you for sharing your story and your music with us. We look forward to seeing how you continue to inspire and impact the world through your art, man. So keep climbing higher and keep spreading your powerful message. Thank you so much, Proclaim.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. I appreciate you. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. All right. Take care, Kate. Take care. Peace.
Bye.
Thank you, my Vigilantes family, as always, for checking out my podcast over here at Vigilantes Radio Live. All episodes are available for free download, and you can grab it from either Spreaker.com/Only One Media Group, Spotify, CastBox, iHeartRadio, iTunes, YouTube, the app Podcast Addict, or over at our website, which again is onlyonemediagroup.com. And that goes for every single show that we've ever aired. If you like to request music or send something for me to play, email it to vradio@onlyonemediagroup.com. That is V as in Victor. And here's my disclaimer. We are genre free. We do not judge, and we absolutely do not base our opinions on hearsay, but facts alone. And actually, scratch all of that, because all of my opinions are always right. That's the bottom line. This is my show, so deal with it. Just kidding. On behalf of myself, Denny, I appreciate all you guys for tuning in, either afterwards or live with us. Spread the word, because sharing is caring. We stepped up our game just for you guys and our guests to make sure that you have the best experience here on our show. Be sure to connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Snapchat, TikTok, at all social media sites, as well as Spreaker, YouTube. We always follow back. Okay, well, just remember to put yourself into everything that you do and never stop investing in yourself. Peace, love, grilled cheese, and talk with you later.
You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, the people's choice for quality interviews, art, music, and hot topics. Hosted by Demetrius Whodini-Blak Reynolds of the duo No Longer the Hero. All episodes of this podcast are available for free download at www.onlyonemediagroup.com. This is a Seventh Sign Regime, Rebirth Worldwide Syndicate exclusive.